Hey friends, it's Tiger. Welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I am here with 10 different museum designs for you guys to use for inspiration or ideas for your museum. I really hope that you guys enjoy this video. It's a little bit different than my usual. So first off, I'm going to show you guys my museum. I have this little trees bounty archway kind of leading up to the museum with this really pretty mind the plants sign. I really like how this area turned out. I just forgot to record for a speed build, so I'm showing you guys now. On the right side, I have this little study area with a little bird cage and some books and plants, so whoever is working at the museum can study their specimens and learn. I also have another similar study space on the beach that has some fish and seaweed, some more papers and books, and more fish. I really liked the way that this area turned out, and on the left side of my museum is pretty simple. There's not much going on over here, it's just a walkway, but I really liked it anyways. So the first museum design that I'm showing you is by Way Blossom on Instagram. You guys should definitely check her out. I love the little trail leading up to the museum area. They also have some study spaces in front of their museum as well. I really like the carpet on the ground right here and the fossil and the little bookshelf with the potions and whatnot. They also had this other study space with a little microscope and some bugs. Again, I really like the study space idea in front of or near your museum. I think it's a really cool concept. Behind the first study space was actually the staircase that led up to the museum itself. I really liked that idea. It's kind of hidden away. And here's the museum up on this cliff, and there's Marshall. So the next design is from Varuna.crossing on Instagram. I hope I said that right. I absolutely adore this design. I love how symmetrical and green it is. It looks so pleasing to the eye. This is definitely more city styled and sophisticated than what I normally post, but I actually really enjoyed it. I think that it looked great. Ethan did such a good job with this museum entrance. It had staircases that led up to it. It was like a super grand entrance, and at the top there was like a little park area with some benches. I love the hedges in this area. I also really liked the wedding archway used right here. It just adds so much to the area. The statues on either side of the museum looked really nice as well, and all of the details put together just look so good, and on each side there was some stepping stones that you could hop across, and it was just really peaceful and really nice. Honestly, I enjoyed visiting this one, and I hope that you guys find some inspiration from it because it is definitely an awesome design. Next up, we have a museum design by Macadamia_ACNH. This one is definitely more towards the cottagecore side of things. It's really natural and earthy. I love the flowers placed in the middle of the pathway. It looks so good. Everything was just so warm and natural. I loved all the browns, and they also had a study space in front of their museum, and it looked really good. I love how they had the screen in front of the bookshelf, and I love how they added the candle as well. And here is this cute tiny little painting area, which I thought added so much to the area. I love how they could fit all this furniture into such a small place. And everything just looks so good. I absolutely love the entire area. Everything just looks so well placed, and I love this little seating area. Next up, we have a design by Blossom_Crossing. This museum looked so peaceful while it was raining. I absolutely loved visiting during a storm. I thought that it just added so much character to the area. I also especially enjoyed her pathway that she used. It looks so nice on the ground. It matches with the flowers so stinking well. They also had some fossils and little signs in front of the museum. I really, really liked the butterfly sign. I thought that it was super adorable. The fossils looked so cool, hidden behind the trees with the rain bouncing off of them. It just gave an overall peaceful vibe, and it was so enjoyable to visit. Next, we headed on over to this beautiful museum created by Katie.ACNH. This one was so colorful and dreamy. I loved the pathway that they used. Everything looked so vibrant, and it was just awesome. They had this natural staircase that led up to this beautiful pathway between these two ponds right in front of their museum. It just looked so amazing. I literally can't get over it. I love the butterfly models and all the little tiny details like the pine cone on the ground. It was just so dreamy and such a treat to visit. On the right side, she had this really awesome terraforming and kind of like a bench looking over it. And then on the left side, she had this awesome cafe kind of hidden across the river, and it just looked so nice and peaceful. I wish that I could visit this coffee cafe in person and drink my little coffee in the woods. It would be so nice. I seriously adore this one. I don't even know how it's possible to create something this beautiful. Honestly, it just looks so nice, and there's so many details throughout the entire area. I love the shell fountain as well. It just looked so lovely. This next design was created by a fellow YouTuber, Red Leaf Pile. You can find her on Instagram and YouTube under the same username. This museum design was so cool. I loved the pathway. It just looked so interesting and unique. She had some paintings up on the cliffs right at the entrance, which I thought added a lot of character and detail to the area. She also had a study space in front of her museum, sorry, with some trophies and a little record player with some fossils around. And there were so many items, but they looked so good together, and everything just worked very well. She also had this tent over on the left side, which I thought was so cool. It fits in perfectly with the museum theme, and yeah, it just looks so nicely and it fits so snug. She also had like a school observation study space going on the beach, and she used such unique items in this area, but it looks so good. I love the bookshelves on the rocks back there. It looked like an actual classroom, which was really, really cool to see. I really, really enjoyed visiting this museum. Definitely check out her YouTube and you guys can see some of her speed builds. I think she did a speed build over this area, so definitely check it out. Next is this design by Flowerly Island on Instagram. This one was so nice and neat and pristine. I loved the staircases leading up to the museum. She had her orchard and a little flower garden in front of the museum, and it just looked so nice and clean, like I said. I really, really liked it. She had this seating area over on the right side with some fossils, and it just looked really, really cool, and I just really enjoyed how satisfying it was. She also had a Starbucks cafe on the left side. I love that she uses the green furniture as well as the green and white stall to match the Starbucks theme. It looked just like a Starbucks. I wish I had some right now. And yeah, I just really, really enjoyed how clear it was. I really like the pathway that she used, and I hope that you guys like this one as well. Next, we have a museum design by mallow.ach. I love how she uses the UFO in front of her museum. It looks so cool, and yeah, it just looks really nice. I also like the staircases kind of creating this grand entrance, and she has a little rocket and an astronaut on the side, kind of overlooking this flower field, which, by the way, was Celeste. It was a Celeste flower field, which is so cool. I was obsessed. And she had a little music space set up on the right side of her museum. I love the star fragments and the piano with the statues. And I really liked how you could see the waves crashing against the beach in the background. It was so peaceful. She also had a little pizza restaurant down at the bottom of the museum. It was so nice with the fire burning at nighttime, and there was some Celeste items. And it really made me hungry, to be honest. Here is a little overview of this area. I really, really enjoyed this one. You guys should definitely check her out on Instagram. Like I said, all of those links will be in the description. Next, we have this jungle-themed museum area by island_life. This was inspired by a World War II story about saltwater crocodiles that had killed some soldiers. I thought that it was really cool that it had such a unique backstory, and I just love this huge land bridge surrounded by this swamp area. The swamp was meant to imitate the crocodile swamp, and I thought that was just so cool. I've never seen a swamp on Animal Crossing before, so I was super intrigued. I also just really liked the pathways that she used. It was so nice. There was a lot of variation, and this land bridge was just so cool. She also had some little critters on the ground in front of her museum, a little centipede and a cockroach. It looked so cool. There was a lot of fossils around the area, and everything just looked like a jungle, honestly. Like, she really did a good job representing that. On the left side, there was a stargazing area, and on the right side, there was this little table setup. She had a little birdcage and a butterfly model. I love how she put the microscope and the fossil right there. I really liked the water features in this area as well. That river looks so amazing and natural, and I literally could never make that. It looks so good. This one was definitely one of my top favorites. It was so unique, and I had never seen anything like it. I definitely enjoyed seeing this and visiting it in person. It was so cool and way better than what it looked like in pictures. Last but not least, we have this museum design by clovercrossing_acnh. I love how she had this beautiful little entrance area to the museum with some fossils and a little picnic area with a butterfly and a painting area. There was a sign that pointed towards the museum, and if you followed it, you went down this really pretty pathway and up this staircase that led into this area where there was a vending machine and a bench. I really liked how there was like this kind of long entrance to get to the museum. It was super cool. And in front of her museum, she had these really cool fossils set up, and it looked so nice with the 5 a.m. skies. I personally love looking at the fossils. And then there was a staircase that led up to the museum. There was this really cool water feature on the left with a statue and a fossil in the middle. I really, really liked that. And the museum itself was situated on top of this cliff with a little bubblegum machine next to it. It looked so nice. And I also, again, really liked the pathways that she used in this area. She also had an area for oddities, which I had never seen anyone do this before, and I thought it was so unique and so cool. I absolutely loved this area. It was so peaceful at 5 a.m., and everything just looked really, really good together. I like how simple it was, but also super intricate and detailed. Alrighty guys, so that was the 10 museum ideas that I have found for you guys. Be sure to follow all of these creators over on Instagram and definitely credit them if you decide to use their museum as inspiration or as an idea for your own. I will definitely put their links in the description as well as Red Leaf Pile's YouTube channel. You guys should definitely check her out. I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video. If you guys want to see another video like this, definitely let me know in the comments. I was thinking about maybe making a campsite idea video for you guys. I hope that you all have a great day. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!